Hello everyone. In this part, we're going to paint details onto our camera using the paint through tool. We've now set up the paint buffer ready for painting these details onto our object. First of all, make sure you have the logo image files from the course downloads. We want to paint each of these into a separate layer so we have control over each of them later in case we need to add adjustments such as brightness. Create a new layer in your layer palette. Activate the paint through tool, clicking this button on the left of the UI, or hitting the U key. This is going to allow us to load in an image from our image manager onto the screen, and when we paint onto the paint buffer, the image is going to be projected onto it. When we first activate the tool, nothing's going to appear. We need to load some images into the image manager first. Open the image manager palette. This essentially just stores and lets you manage all the images you load into your project. You can right-click the empty window to open up some images and add them to your image manager. Navigate to the logo images provided by the course files. We have some advanced options here that allow us to control the color space and the alpha of the images we're importing. We want to keep the images as automatic, and what this does is determine the color space that the image should be assigned based on what project color settings we have. In our project, we kept everything as default in the color settings tab. So for any 8-bit or 16-bit images we import here, if we have automatic selected, they are going to be assigned the sRGB color space. However, there may be cases where you're not working with color data, but something called scalar data. If we take a look at our channels palette, next to our channel, you can see an icon that shows the channel is using color data. If we're importing images into a channel that uses scalar data, indicated by a black and white icon like this, then the automatic setting will be set to raw or linear, depending on the project's color settings. We'll cover scalar data later in the series, but you can also check out the Mari docs about color versus scalar data to learn more. The alpha dropdown lets us decide what to do with any alpha component in our images. We definitely want to retain transparency data in these images because we use transparency in all of them to only transfer a decal of the logo. We want to leave the alpha channel as it is in the original file, so let's select Leave from the dropdown. Select all the images and click Open. Now the images are stored in the manager. Drag one of the logos from the image manager onto the viewport to load it into the paint through tool. To scale this loaded image up and down in the viewport, hold Ctrl and Shift and click drag your mouse from left to right. To rotate the image, hold Ctrl and click drag your mouse left to right. And to move the image, hold Shift, click and drag the mouse to set the image where you need. If you need to reduce the image's opacity so you can see what you're doing a bit easier, hold Shift and press plus or minus buttons. Once the image is in the spot where you want to project the image down, click and drag over the image to project it onto the paint buffer. Remember to hit the B key to bake the paint buffer down once you've projected the image, and then Ctrl, Shift and C to clear the buffer once you're done with an image. You won't need to do this if you have the default bake behaviour of auto bake and clear. This will all happen automatically. Let's rename the layer we just painted into so we know what's inside. Double click the layer and then just enter a new name and then hit enter. Repeat this with the other two images, making sure you paint each of these images to its own layer, just so we can manage them easier if we need to later. In the case of the Lubitel sticker, it doesn't fit exactly on the geometry. We can fix this by getting it as close to the reference as possible using the paint through transform tools and then painting over the image. We're actually able to transform the paint we've just painted into the paint buffer by going to the transform paint buffer tool on the left side of the UI or by hitting the M key. Now you can move the paint in the paint buffer around, scale or rotate it. In our case, I think we need to squash the image slightly on the y-axis. So if we hover our mouse over the top of the paint buffer, we can squash the paint along the y-axis. Make any adjustments you need and then hit the B key once you're happy and clear the buffer. This is a really great tool if paint you've laid down needs scaling, rotating, or moving. While painting onto the paint buffer, you can erase any mistakes using the paint buffer eraser tool or pressing the E key. You cannot erase any painting you've already baked down in this way. If you need to erase a painting you've already baked onto the object, select the layer where the paint lives and activate the paint tool with the P key. Set the painting mode to clear and paint over the texture you want to erase. You can see that it clears the paint data there. Then hit the B key as normal to bake and then clear the buffer with Ctrl Shift and C. Remember to set painting mode back to normal afterwards, so next time you paint you don't start erasing existing paint. If you feel like either of those layers we've just painted down need contrast or brightness adjusting, we can add an adjustment to the layer. Right click the layer you want to add an adjustment to, go to Adjustment Stack, Add Adjustment Stack. I think we could do with a slight gain in the white levels, so I'm going to select the Levels option. An adjustment layer has been added to our layer, indicated by this icon here. If we click the icon, it will take us to our adjustment stack. Here we can see the levels layer we just added. Select that and you can adjust the levels properties below. That's looking good. Now I can close the adjustment stack window. If you ever need to go back to it, remember just click the icon. You can actually add as many adjustments as you like into this adjustment stack, so you can be really flexible with the effect you add to your layer. In the next episode, we're going to create wear and tear on the camera using masks. See you then.